Zeus. You must bring an end to this. They attack our temples.
Now they dare to desecrate Zeus's image.
We could reach out to them.
An accommodation could be made. A truce!
Now! I created them. And they reward my love with defiance? There will be no truce.
Find me some rage from you. How long has it been? How long, brother, since you've seen my face?
Hades.
The Sumerian Chaldean art depicts the trial of Adam. Here, Adam is labeled as the son of the god Aya, also known as Jove, Zeus, and Indra. Originally a god with a lion head. Initially, I thought this was the prefix La, which has a negative implication. But after looking through the Sumerian Lexicon Dictionary, I discovered there is no Aya or Aya. In ancient Egypt, there is a god of the moon named Aya. The god Aya was assimilated with Osiris, a deity within a deity. But in Sumerian, Aya may be La. Separately, the I and the H do relate to the character, but together as Aya, they do not. But La, Lal, and Lil certainly do. I will work through the variants of the word elements, then I will list them for you. This way we can see, based on the language, whether or not this is a good god, or a god of a more dangerous kind. I in Sumerian, meaning cry of pain. Derived from ear, meaning tears, complaint. Alternatively, to capture, defeat, overcome. The letter A, water, watercourse, canal, seminal fluid, offspring, father, tears, flood. If means tears, then Plato's Book of could be the Book of Lamentation. And if is derived from then it may be the Book of the Wolf, Zeus Lyacon. Either way, they refer to the father of tears, lamentation.
To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentation of your women.
The works of Plato and other Greek writers were admittedly derived from ancient Babylon by the order of Plato himself. Plato would also be responsible for the demise of the Titan Tityos via the flick of a quill. This would be assimilation, Plato could be defined as a secret shirk, as it is clear that the local hero cult had been superseded by the cult of the Olympian gods, with an Olympian father provided and the hero demonized. The new father would be Jove, later known as Zeus. This would be a very good definition for the name Aya. The Greek god of wolves is Leto, otherwise known as Laia, and his son Hermes created the Laia. Hermes with Tahut, Tahut with Aya, and originally Tahut was Shesmu. The lamentation rites, the magical hymns and prayers, were created by Enki to appease Abzu, the father of Mamu and Zu, who is yet another lion-faced figure. The Book of the Dead was copied and altered, giving rise to Tahut, concealing Shesmu, a god within a god, a wheel within a wheel. Aya, the sound you make when you stump your toe on a rock. Aya can mean V, or five, and could also relate to anointing. La, abundance, luxury, wealth, youthful freshness and beauty, happiness, wish, desire. La, to penetrate, pierce, force a way into, to know, to look after, to have a beard. Lalbar, a mythological lake, pond, honey, date syrup, plus ring. As previously mentioned, the Greek god of wolves is Leto, the symbols for whom are the veil. Dates, the palm tree. The rooster. The wolf, the griffin, and the weasel, otherwise known as Laia. Lal, to be high, to hold, to lift, to carry. To hang from, with tar. To weigh, to pay, to deduce, to strap, harness, with shy, to dress oneself, to place, set, to bind a reed pillar, to stretch, extend, reach, to load, to lessen, be few, diminish, to accuse, denounce, to fall back, retreat. And the reduplicated Ila, to carry, support, light deficient, minus. Lal relates to La, and La relates to Lal. Together they form Lalal. Al-Al with Ul-Al. Ulal. Noose. Lasso. To hang. Suspend. To bind. To silence. Lal is honey, or date syrup, reduplicated as La, a luxury, bliss, cognate with Lalu, debt, owed amount, La'aya ni, arrears, debt arrears, ni is melum, a substance worn by the Anunnaki. If they do indeed exist, they feed on fear. Lalu is the fear of debt, or possibly the fear of the wolf father. In relation to debt, the next word is Lala, shortage, deficiency. The reduplicated Lal, La. Light deficient. It is bright, but there is no light within its body. That would be light deficient. The vowels are interchangeable, leading us to another storm god, Enlil. En means lord or earth. But N also relates to Mamu, in Sumerian Onum. Onum, a title of respect, from the Emesal dialect version form of N. Omun, mold, raw form or material. For example, clay, to mold an idea, to mold knowledge. To mold scholarship. Omun, flea, louse, a blood-sucking parasite. That would be the origin of the plague. Omun, a stagnant pool, a swamp plant, a god of the unclean waters. Lil appears to mean babbling, but with intent. Lil, fool, moron, a Lalitation word, meaning unintelligible baby talk. Or Lal, La, to carry deficiency, deficiency in light. Lil also means wind, breath, infection, spirit of a place. This would imply an infected breath. Lil, to infect. Lull, liar, lie, malicious act. To lie, to deceive. Reduplicated as Lu, to trouble, to disturb. The adjectives are false, treacherous, malicious. so below. Al-Al is a demon, a liar and deceiver. In Greek, Leia means fair of speech or well-spoken. My friends, don't be so easily deceived. Language changes, but the original meaning and purpose do not. You know fine well, those of fair speech and the well-spoken are usually those who deceive.